here. It's October, finally. I chose you. You are worth anything that we've gone through, are going through, will go through in the future. I am willing to fight for you. I am signing a covenant between you and me, and in front of these people as our witnesses. And I love you. I will always be there for you.
Today, Justin and Stephanie have come to be united together in the covenant of marriage. To be bound by a promise of love, you have come here as two, but you leave as one. So Justin, before God and these witnesses, do you, Justin, take Stephanie to be your wife? Will you love and comfort her, honor and keep her, and enjoy and sorrow, preserve with her this bond, holy and unbroken until the return of Christ Jesus? Or as long as you both may live. It's wonderful. Stephanie, before God and these witnesses, do you, Stephanie, take Justin to be your husband? Will you love and comfort him, honor and keep him? And enjoy and sorrow, preserve with him this bond, holy and unbroken, until the return of Christ Jesus. Or as long as you both shall live, so say I do. It's a good thing as well. So, I've known these guys for the better part about 10 years, ranging back into the college ministry. And I think I met Justin the first time through maybe Mike Best years ago. And one of the first things that stood out about Justin was how funny he was. His humor, his sarcasm. But he also just loved to be with his friends. He enjoyed them. Another thing that I noticed was that you had a heart to serve. You were always willing to learn something new and apply that, whether it was through ministry or relationship. I see how you love Stephanie and Hazel even now, and how you've already begun to lay down your life for them. It's very admirable. Stephanie, I met you years ago as well, perhaps before the college ministry, and the thing that stood out about the most about you was your love to serve in ministry as well. When the church was going through so many different people in different ministries, I could always count on you to do your best and to be there, which was hard to find back then. I've also seen you as your life dramatically changed with the birth of Hazel. Your love and care for her came far before your own self. You laid down your life for your daughter, and you continue to do so. It's beautiful. No matter what the circumstances, you're willing to lay aside yourself for the better of others.
Your love has ravished my heart and taken me over. now pronounce your husband and wife. Your God has joined together, let no man separate. Yes? Yeah, it's your God.
The bride and the groom agree. If they vote that the answer is the bride, they're going to raise her shoe. And if they think that it is the groom, they're going to raise his shoes. So here we go. The first one. Who will wake up first in the morning? Who cleans more?
Still thinking.
Who makes all the decisions? Who is more likely to run a red light? Who spends more money? Who watches more TV? Who has the bigger wardrobe? We didn't say who's top. He just let the shoe. Who is grumpier in the morning? Who is more stubborn? Who is a better driver? Last one is, who is always right?
Why are they going?
You are a promise. You are a song. Smooth like a waterfall. A sea in the calm. You are the summer. You are the sun. You are the desert plain where the wild horses run. I want you to know you are the first thought. I want you to know the grace you're made of. I want you to feel that you're mine, dear.
My name is Mike. Best. And I am the best man. Alright, me and Justin went to high school together and been one of the consistent and constant friends in my life, and he's awesome. And
thank you.
A lot of you guys know the snarky, quick-witted guy on Facebook, but I've gotten to see for a long time the guy who can write something in a greeting card that can make my wife cry, no joke. And
In a good way.
Stephanie, to be honest, I haven't really known you that long, or I don't know you that much, but first time I met you was I had just taken over the worship stuff for the youth, and some girl I don't know comes up and goes, so here's the schedule of all the people who are going to be running PowerPoint for your worship stuff, and I kind of had that up, and you don't have to worry about that. And I like this girl. Because I was way over my head. I'm going to keep this short, but basically, love you guys, and to kind of brag on something Justin said to me, and kind of use it back on him, in a card he gave me yesterday saying, thanks for being the best man, he said some stuff about how he's kind of like watched me be Insta-dad, and kind of, we call it Insta-dad, pretty similar situation. He got to say that I know that if you center yourself in Christ and if you make that your main focus, anything can work out with the family. And pretty much that's all he needed to say is that if that's his attitude, if he's going into this as the leader of the household and he is centering his mind on Christ, instead of assume and hope he'll do the same. I just haven't talked to him about this before. You know, you get to know for a fact that the marriage is going to work out great, and even in the roughest times, he's still centered on Christ and everything's good.
That's okay. Tell them again. All right, break it up.
Okay, I am the matron of honor. My name is Catherine Chapman, and I've had the privilege of knowing Stephanie for maybe about 3 years now. She started coming to our home fellowship at church, but first I'm going to talk about Justin.
I like where this goes.
And I've known of you for a long time, and we've just recently, other than our Facebook overboard. I'm really glad to know you, and I love your humor, but more I love your heart, and I've seen you loving my friend very well. And very selflessly, and I'm just very grateful that all our prayers for Stephanie has been answered, and that you, you're going to make a really good husband, and I'm so glad that you were able to speak at Denny's, and that I was able to know your heart, and hear from you, and hear from you, and I approve of this marriage. And Stephanie, I love you a lot. I think you know that. And I'm so excited to see how far you've come. And I know sometimes there are seasons in life that if we look at them, we feel like we're not growing and that we're not, maturing. But if you look back far enough, you can see from how far you've come. And I love that you have had an open heart to the Lord and an open heart to others, and you let us correct you and redirect you and speak into your life, and that you let us watch over your soul with joy. You know, that you're not a grief to us most of the time. But I love that your heart is so open and willing, and that you let us love you. And I'm very excited to be a part of your life, and that this is just the beginning.
I love what's going on with you guys with Hazel, and how Hazel now probably has a larger pool of men to choose from than my son. So she's not marrying my 5-year-old, almost 6-year-old. So again, I want to make sure it's public.
They're still the trope, okay?
No, they're not. Both parents have to be. Anyway, I just wanted to bless you guys and say that I know that just through some of the conversations we've had in the last few days, as the stress gets higher, it's easy to kind of let that kind of take over, and
I think anybody who has gone through the whole wedding thing feels that, you know. But there's those times where you just kind of have to let things go because the greater side of this whole thing is tomorrow. You know, this is fun. We're going to remember half of it, maybe a third of it. But what you're going to be looking at is what you're building towards tomorrow. And the conversations we had, I love that you guys have both kind of made decisions now, early on, to say, like, when things get hard or things that I don't understand, I'm going to choose to love beyond myself. Where I don't understand stuff, I'm still going to love anyway, and not just demand my own way. The shoe thing, when they said, who's always right? They both looked at the other person's shoe, is that right?
Yeah.
The other person's shoe, that was awesome. I thought that was like prophetic, you know? So I think that's like a great foundation. So I just want to say congratulations and bless you. And I chose to the bride and groom. Ching ching.
Cheers.
Are we dancing?
People better dance.
Let's dance.
Let it out.
Beatbox amongst yourselves.